Hi all, subscribe to our channel on YouTube and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. For course inquiries, visit our website www.gatelectures.com and don't forget to register and subscribe to the latest post section.
Now in the previous video, we discussed about the transmission and propagation delay. In this video, we'll discuss about the queuing delay and the processing delay. Now we know what is the transmission delay, we know what is the propagation delay. Now when this data packet will be reaching to this place, or you can say when this data packet will reach to the receiver, now the receiver is not going to take this data packet directly, it is going to wait for some time. That means sometimes if the sender is sending data to the receiver, now the receiver is always not at a position to accept the data packet instantaneously. Okay, just for example, let us say I'm making a call to you. I called you. Now maybe you are busy in some other work, maybe you are busy in kitchen, maybe you are playing football, maybe you are chit-chatting with your friends, maybe you are doing some other work. Now what will you do? You'll keep my phone on hold for some time and then you'll pick my call. Okay, so in the same way, when this data packet will reach to the receiver, now receiver sometimes is maybe busy doing some other task, or you can say the processor may be busy doing some other task. In that case, a receiver will keep this data packet on hold, and to keep this on hold, receiver is going to place this in terms of a queue. So receiver is also going to maintain a queue here. There's a queue here that receiver is going to maintain. In this queue, whenever data packet is received, receiver will place this data packet inside this queue. It is going to place these data packets inside this queue. And when the receiver is ready to process the data packet, it will take the data packet, it is take the first data packet, and then it is going to process it. Remember, it is a queue. And what is the property of the queue? If this came first, then this will be processed first, and everything that will be added will be in the last position like this. Okay. Now, the time for which the data packet waited in the queue, or the time for which the data packet is staying in the queue, that is called as queuing delay. That is called as queuing delay. And after waiting in the queue, the receiver is going to take this data packet and then it is going to process it. The time taken to process is called as processing delay. It is called as processing delay. But there is a very interesting fact here, that we have no idea what will be the queuing delay and we have no idea what will be the processing delay. Okay, sometimes the receiver may be busy, or you can say the operating system of the receiver may be busy in doing some other task. It may not be available instantaneously, and it will do so, it will make the data packet wait. But in some cases, the processor will be available and instantaneously it can process the data packet. So this queuing delay is not at all constant. It is always changing and it is not fixed. So there's no way of finding out what will be the queuing delay at specific time, because we know exactly what will be the propagation delay. We know exactly what will be the transmission delay, because those things are fixed. Why? Because the speed of the signal is fixed and the distance between the sender and the receiver is fixed. So it is not going to change. And the transmission time is also not going to change, because size of the data packet is also fixed and the bandwidth is also fixed. Now, in some cases, if the size of the data packet is changing, then in that case also, we can exactly find out what will be the transmission delay. But this queuing delay is actually dependent on what is the state of the system. State of the system, or you can say, what is the state of the processor at the receiver's end. So we cannot find out exactly what will be the queuing delay, and we cannot find out exactly what will be the processing delay, because this processing delay may also vary according to the processor. Let us say you are having a very old processor. It is a Pentium 4 processor, Pentium 3 processor, and there's some data packet. Now this P4 or P3 processor will take more time to process the data packet as compared to all the latest generation processors. Or you can say, if let us say you have a mobile phone. Now for this mobile phone, the processors are not very, very powerful as compared to your computer system processor. So it may happen that the mobile phone processor may take some time to process the data packet as compared to your computer system. So this processing delay is not at all fixed at all. So there is no way to find out what is the queuing delay, and there's no way of finding out what is the processing delay. But still, we have to measure these values because in some questions, they give you what will the processing delay, what will be the queuing delay. And here, we are representing this queuing delay as TQ, and we are representing this processing delay as TP. Okay. So when I'm saying what is the total delay of sending a data packet from the sender to the receiver, then total delay can be found out as a transmission delay. That first of all, we are going to have a transmission delay. Then we are going to have a propagation delay. Then we are going to have a queuing delay. And then we are going to have a processing delay. Queuing delay and the processing delay. So this is the total delay that we are going to have to send a data packet to the sender and the receiver. Sender to the receiver. Now, if in the question, this queuing delay or this processing delay, they are given, then you have to take it. And if this queuing delay and processing delay is not given, then you are going to assume that these are equivalent to zero. These are equivalent to zero. In that case, the total delay to send one data packet from the sender to the receiver will be equal to transmission time plus propagation time. Transmission time plus propagation time. So that will be the total delay for this particular case. Okay. Now let us move forward in the next video.